Nick is never afraid to explore, to surprise, to provoke, to stimulate. So strap on your seatbelts. This is going to be quite a ride. It is an honor to welcome Nicholas Graham.
Oh! Good morning, class. It's great to be here today. Just a couple of housekeeping matters. The use of hair and makeup, there will be no hair and makeup today. The role of Anna Winter will be played by you. And Naomi Campbell will be played by me. My philosophy of the Joe Boxer brand has always been the brand is the amusement park and the product is a souvenir, which is the idea that brands are basically emotions. That's all they are. And the product is a souvenir of those emotions. And so brands can play political, religious, environmental, artistic, humorous, destructive, peaceful, wasteful, or resourceful. But brands can be late for work, wear toupees, sleep in, drink too much, get married, write bad romance novels, and trash hotel rooms. How can brands do that? Because brands are human. And another word for human is people. So the idea that brands are really people, and they come from people. And so the idea, take it even further, is if anyone can build a product, but not everyone can build a brand. And so the difference between a product and a brand is really memory. And how you create that memory. How do you create that memory? How do you make that memory happen? And what makes a brand memorable, really, is emotions. And I know you thought you came to an underwear presentation. But the idea of that, and this is where the name 100 Minutes comes from, is if the age of the universe was compressed to 100 minutes, then the entire length of human civilization and memory would only account for 5/1,000ths of a second of that 100 minutes. So, again, you use scale. And the idea of the 100 minutes is to make it, you can deal with very large concepts by breaking them down into very manageable concepts, which is really what brands are. And then taking that further, the entire length of human civilization were compressed to 100 minutes, that we landed on the moon 2 seconds ago. So, I know, scale, it's fun. And taking further, the amount of time since we landed on the moon were compressed to 100 minutes, that we landed on Mars 15 seconds ago. I don't care if you're a fashion designer or a taxi driver, an architect, in order to create history, you have to understand where you are in it. And that's the point of this work. I developed this idea, what I call the brand map. And in that brand map, I developed this idea using the powers of 10 to brand scale. So 10 to the power of 0 would be me, which is who you are. 10 to the power of 1 is motive, which is what drives you. 10 to the 2 is make, which is what you create. 10 to the power of 3 is money, which is how you create value. 10 to the power of 4 is message, which is your voice. 5 is media, which is how you deliver the message. 10 to the power of 6 is market, which is what your audience is. 10 to the power of 7 is mind share, which is the awareness. 10 to the power of 8 is meaning, which is irrelevance. And 10 to the power of 9 is memory, which is brand. Finally, memory is brand, is basically how do you want to be remembered. So you take all these people and all their stories, and none of their stories would really mean anything without these people. So, which is people. So you have to get the memory across. And people plus people equals community, and a community equals a brand. So, taking it even further, brand, again, is amusement park. So the more powerful the souvenir, the more valuable the amusement park, and the more powerful the amusement park, the more valuable the souvenir. And so if cascades are created by a single drop of water, and brands are created by individuals, then in order to create a brand, you need to be you. Any questions?
So there's a brand.
Amazing. It was just amazing. It talks to us as people about what we don't think about every day and what goes on around us, but we never take time to think about it. I'm Stacy Shefflin of Models Prefer. I have a QVC brand. I'm in 84 million households. And if people received me like I just received that presentation on my brand and what I build every day, I mean, we'd be five times bigger than what we are now. We just have to think about who we are, what they want, and how to offer it to them. It's an amazing presentation. Anybody in business should see that presentation.
Nick Graham was just absolutely terrific, and his message is wonderful, and he's an incredibly charismatic and appealing performer, as well as having something that's quite wonderful to say to everybody. And the message is motivating and rather uplifting as well. It's a true success story.
It was a terrific presentation. He's brilliant, he's funny, he's smart, he's entertaining, but he's all about the simplicity of branding and the importance of branding. I would never miss an opportunity to hear a presentation from him.
Yeah, it's really thought-provoking. You know, I think the way the images come together, it's not at all what you think of when you think you're going to hear a lecture.
Nick is always so funny, and he injects so much humor into his presentation that it makes it more interesting. And the way he analyzes how we remember things, I think, is what was most impactful.
I find it to be extraordinarily moving, motivating, inspiring, and it just makes you want to take off in some incredible trajectory and succeed at whatever it is you're doing, whether it's large scale, it's small scale, doesn't really matter, but just to be yourself and to succeed at what you want to do, it's an extraordinary experience.